Dear colleagues, good evening. I hope you and your families are all safe, healthy, and doing as well as you possibly can in the face of this global pandemic. My name is Grigoriadis Stavros. I'm a radiologist in hospital at ECOL. This presentation is about effectiveness and safety of fusion imaging. Fusion imaging is the outcome of the work and commitment between medical industries and scientific partners who put out our disposal competence and passion for research to reach common goals and improve healthcare within everyday clinical practice, interventional procedures, research, teaching, and further development may draw a promising future driven by ultrasound. Interventional procedures have some current limitations. For example, in ultrasound modality, many lesions are invisible or inaccessible. They need highly operator-dependent and poor global visibility. CT has radiation exposure. Off-axis approach is often challenging. Lesions transiently visible with contrast. MR need complicated procedural environment. Limited availability, costly procedure. The purpose of fusion imaging is to enhance the image produced by an ultrasound scanner by means of combining them with a second modality in real time. They can define organ conspicuity, confirm contrast uptake, delineate and follow up lesion, confirm ablation pattern. Why fusion imaging? Fusion imaging takes advantages of its modality, providing you real-time imaging with accurate navigation for lesions localizations. Finally, it can provide more accuracy and reliability for pathology diagnosis, intervention procedures, and treatment evaluations. We can detect lesions through CT, MRI, or PET that are inconspicuous to ultrasound. Suggest the best scan approach to better identify the target and identifications of safety pathway. Complex angle of insertions, dumb lesions, lesions under ribs that provoke acoustic shadows in ultrasound, easily drive the operator in the region of interest, localizing specific part of tumor for biopsies, example areas that are hot on PET CT. Fusion imaging is the future. In the present era of multimodality imaging of human body, the present emphasis is one of the fusion of information achieved from different images modality. Fusion imaging takes all the advantages of different imaging modalities. Actually, each modality has its own advantages and disadvantages. Ultrasound is real-time, flexible, and no patient radiation. But it has relatively lower resolution and patient-dependent, easily be affected by bone, gas, etc. CT and MRI, in contrary, has higher spatial resolution and no patient-dependent, but it's static image and brings radiation exposure to patients. So we can take all these advantages, we can combine them to increase diagnostic confidence. Fusion imaging is one static and one dynamic for interventional procedures. So, the equipment we have in the picture in the left corner, we have the magnetic field generator, which is located near the patient, creates a magnetic field, thereby inducing currents in the position sensor, which is mounted on the US transducer, as we can see in the image below. As the US probe moves, the magnitude of the electric current in the position sensor changes with respect to the magnetic field. Another sensor is the respirator compensation. It's optional, we can explain this later. And the electromagnetic needle tracking, which creates a magnetic field, who can visualize the tip of the needle. So, a non-intrinsic real-time modality with a real-time modality can volume co-registration and give us interactive localization modalities. What is wrong with this picture? This is that what we call cognitive fusion. You can see a radiologist giving directions to the orthopedics in order to approach the suprapatellar recess. The wrong in this picture is that the radiologist is looking at the screen of ultrasound, the orthopedist, the patient. But if we had a fusion imaging, we have a real-time ultrasound with a static modality in order to better approach our target. Many times we have a respirator moving artifacts, and in these cases we can use the sensor that I showed you before. In order to perform the compensation, you just need to set a signal loop with an extra respiration sensor. Then, based on the signal loop, the system can build up a 3D modeling movement, and finally, the system can integrate the model for respiration compensations. In our department, a total of 60 patients underwent percutaneous fusion guides technique. Technical success was feasible in all cases. Comparing the fusion guided results with those of biopsies under ultrasound guidance performed in the same period, there was no statistical significant difference in terms of technical success and complications. Breast is an organ with it is a case of our department. Breast is an organ with very high deformations since it's highly dependent on density itself. The axilla, instead, is an easier access point to reach lesions. Once the one-play registration is performed, it's possible fine-tuning with manual rotations of the second modality. The real-time hemodynamic evaluation and color Doppler overlapping features help to confirm the quality of registration and eventually apply a further tuning before approaching the target. You can see in the first picture our needle in the center of the lesion. In the second picture is an MRI image. Once the correlation has been performed, the target can be reached with the easiest scanning approach, even in hard cases such as biopsies of kidney. The future is future developments, faster and seamless registration, reliable and easy reproducible registrations. Co-registrations of MRI and real-time ultrasound enable sonographic localization of breast lesions detected at MRI only. If a lesion we can see in MRI with contrast enhanced and we can visualize in ultrasound, we can undertake a biopsy with fusion image. Among men undergoing biopsy for suspected prostate cancer, compared with standard ultrasound-guided biopsy, was associated with increased detection of high-risk prostate cancer. Future studies will be needed to assess the ultimate clinical implications of target biopsy. The advantages of fusion imaging is precision and reliability, flexibility, low complexity, low cost, excellent teaching tool, is a great potential for young residents, no radiation exposure, and the limitations are need for ultrasound training, co-registration, occasionally challenging. So, fast, easy to use and low cost tool, real-time imaging with high spatial contrast resolution of CT and MRI, increased precision and accuracy of procedures, reduced duration and number of ablation sessions. Thank you for your attention. Wishes for staying safe.